Hello, people. In community medicine, they can ask you pasteurization of milk, okay? So basically, pasteurization of milk was given by whom? By Louis Pasteur, right? Hence the name pasteurization. You can not only do it for milk, for juices, beverages, everything you can do, okay? This is the pasteurization unit if you have seen in the milk dairies. So basically, it's a physical method of sterilization. You're using moist heat, which is below 100 degrees centigrade, okay? So there are three methods actually: Holder method, flash method, and then there is some ultra high temperature method. Okay. Anyways, the flash method is the most used one. So look at this one. This one is most used. See, remember the Holder method: 63 degrees centigrade you will heat it to, for 30 minutes you will leave it there. Minutes, okay. Flash method, you will heat it to 72 degrees centigrade. You will heat it even more higher and you will maintain it just for 20 seconds. Okay, at least 20 seconds. So just remember here 2, 2 and this is seconds. Okay. The first one was minutes, guys. This one is seconds. This one is the one that is mainly used. The flash method is most used. Okay. And then you will rapidly cool it to plus 13 degrees centigrade. Some books are saying plus 4 degrees centigrade. So just check this. Okay. It is all plus. That's what you have to remember. Cooling means you'll suddenly think it'll become like ice or something. No, it is just cool to positive temperature only or lower. So that is plus 4, you can remember, right? Then you have the ultra high temperature method. Okay. This one, in ultra high temperature method, they are going to use two stages. Actually, they're using plus 125 degrees centigrade and two stages where the second stage is using pressure. Okay. So guys, here what and all will be killed. You look at that in pasteurization of milk, what and all will be killed? Non-sporing pathogens. Mycobacteria, tuberculosis won't happen, brucellosis won't happen, salmonella, that is salmonella typhi, etc. are killed, okay? But what aren't killed are Coxsalia burnetii. It is not killed in this Holder method, but in flash method it's killed, so okay. So anyways, you're doing flash method only, so even this one, the one that causes Q fever, Coxsalia burnetii also will be gone. Okay, what about spores? Some things are saying spores are not killed, so you'll have to maintain the temperature in such a way that they don't germinate. Is that the right word, guys? Okay, moving on, we are looking at pasteurization of milk. So basically, there are some tests to check whether there is effectiveness, test to check whether the milk is pasteurized. So you have the phosphatase test, then you have the two more tests. Phosphatase test, okay, we will come to that. Then you have the standard plate count where you will count the bacteria. They said that the limit should be per ml of pasteurized milk, it should be less than 30,000 bacteria count. Okay, 30,000 bacteria count, it should be less. This looks very high to me. Anyways, coliform count, there should be no coliform in milk. Pasteurized milk should not have any coliform. Coliform means what? E. coli. There should be no, not even one should be there. Okay, because these are completely destroyed by pasteurization. Okay, so what else are we looking at? So which are the three tests you saw? Phosphatase test, standard plate count and coliform count. Okay. Phosphatase test you have already seen. Remember, you will add to the milk disodium phenyl phosphate, and this one will react with the phosphatase enzyme which is present in the milk. This phosphatase enzyme is present only in raw milk. So the milk will turn blue. If it turns blue, that means it contains phosphatase. That means it is raw milk. This phosphatase enzyme has not been destroyed. Actually, this enzyme was supposed to get destroyed by pasteurization. Okay. So look at this. Phosphatase test you have already seen in separate video. Anyways, look at this. To milk, you are adding disodium phenyl phosphate buffer and Fehling's reagent to give you the color. So basically, what will happen? Raw milk will turn blue. Okay. So raw milk will turn blue because it has this enzyme phosphatase. But when you pasteurize the milk, the phosphatase enzyme got destroyed. So there is no reaction. Milk will remain white. Even if it is partially pasteurized, you can get this blue color. Because partially pasteurized will still have this phosphatase enzyme. Okay. So the way this reaction works is disodium phenyl phosphate buffer will react with this phosphatase enzyme, which is present in raw milk, giving phenol. The Fehling reagent will react with phenol and give the blue color. Okay. So who will give blue color, guys, in phosphatase test? Raw milk or partially pasteurized milk also can give that. Incomplete pasteurized milk also can give blue. So remember, this test is positive if you get blue. Incompletely pasteurized. Pasteurized also, it is possible. Okay, then you have strips like this also ready made. You can guess there is just one more test which is actually not related to pasteurization directly, but you can still write this methylene blue reduction test. Basically, you can detect microorganisms. Okay, so this is raw milk. Raw milk has microorganisms, so it gives very different kinds of colors. Okay, and how fast it changes color will indicate how contaminated it is with microorganisms. So what are you adding? You're adding just methylene blue. Okay, you're adding methylene blue to the sample. Okay, and it will just be blue. You're adding blue, it will just be blue in pasteurized or no microorganisms. If there are no microorganisms, it will remain blue. But if microorganisms are there, then the blue is destroyed and it becomes some color like this. Okay? So remember, in methylene blue test, blue color is good. But in phosphatase test, blue color is bad. You understood, right? Did it become too much? At least remember one thing. Phosphatase test, blue is bad. That's it in pasteurization. So this much is the summary of this video, isn't it? That's it, guys. Bye bye.